Jugend. That's about it. It could be the preamp.
Yeah, working now.
Oh, okay.
Preamp's next. Hello, testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
What's that noise?
Preamp.
Well, it's a bit of radio noise or something.
Wi-Fi. It's digital, isn't it? Listen.
No use of that word.
Hello, testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Right, so once again, this is William DeFerra's launch for school in Essex. We'll be launching this payload here, which is very up themed. With a Raspberry Pi in the sky in it, so it should be sending some nice pictures to the ground. So we're just going to set up and you can watch the launch. That's still working. Yeah. Right. So let's get set up. Okay. So I'm just laying out a nice plastic sheet, a nice clean plastic sheet, to ensure that when I put the balloon on, there's a nice sterile environment, no bits of dust or dirt or leaves or leafy bits of grass. Using a line there which will connect through a regulator to the cylinders of helium. Okay, well the next job is to string all the payloads together and switch them on to make sure that they're working. So, turn this one on last actually. The batteries can be a bit critical. Here's a little tracker. That's just something I'm tying on to make sure that if that one packs up, we get it back. So I'm going to use about 5 meters of line between the parachute and the balloon, and about 10 meters of line below the parachute down to the payload, with the little tracker that I've got there in between. So roughly, I don't measure this out particularly accurately, I use about 3 spans and a bit, give me 5 meters, so we call that 5 meters. One that's going to go up on the top of the parachute to the balloon. It's just tying a loop in it now. That's what I do, make things a bit easier. And that loop's pretty much impossible to untie. And get a parachute. I'm going to be using a large parachute today just because I want to get it to glide a bit further. Some predictions. I'm using a 5 foot chute. So this will probably bring it down slightly slower than usual, but that's fine. Payload is around about a kilo with the additional tracker, which only weighs about 50 grams, so just a bit under a kilo in all. So the 5 foot chute is a bit of overkill. Right. So now measuring out 10 meters. Roughly. 7 spans. We'll do the same again at the bottom of the chute. Local nature getting in the way there, trying to tangle up my string. Okay. Right, there's the payload. Okay. Okay.
Yep.
Okay. I just will dangle down in line with the main line. Okay, going to connect up the line to the payload. done. I'm going to take some of these lines up a little bit higher up the halo, just to make sure that on launch they don't get in the way. The tracks are working. Do you really want to take the camera off?
Yeah, I've stopped it. We'll go to the computer.
I think the radio's on and stuff. That one's charged. So do you want to, I'll just explain what we're doing.
What, now?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm just putting on an antenna, which we'll use during the chase, and connecting that up to the radio. Old FD817 here primarily because I had it years and it works every time. So that's the backup tracker. That seems to be working. Let's just check if we can get that. Seems to have got a position, just wait for the next string time. So it's given the position out and we'll just check in a minute and see if that's on the map. That should now be on tracking map. Showing us position where we are. So, okay, we'll turn on the other payload just to check if it's working. I think I'll turn it off again, then fill the balloon, and I'll turn it on again. Let's see what we do. I might change my mind on that.
Okay, stop.
Want to do a bit more?
Yeah, what do you want to do?
I'm just going to do another bit about the make sure that the other payload's working and. So just
hold on. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I've just turned on the Pie in the Sky payload, so we're checking if that's been working as well. Receiving
the position.
Yep,
there's the position. Well, that's sending its position, okay. That should be sending some pictures. Let's have a quick look on that. Yep, looks like it's sending something. Go on the FSTV page. Okay, we're getting our first image coming through. Takes a long time, but it is what it is. Right, okay, that's working nicely. So really all that remains now is to fill the balloon, tie on the payloads. No, they're all done. So yeah, fill the balloon and best first to call the local airfield just to make sure that we were allowed to launch and haven't got a flight incoming or something. Okay,
that's good.
So is that it? That is really it, isn't it? Everything's tied on,
payload.
Everything's working, okay.
I'll snap you when you're doing the call.
Okay.
So if you do it from there, that'll look
quite good. Yep, I'll do it from here.
times for that. Hello, Bourne, it's the guys at New Farm in Ellsworth here. We're launching balloons again today, so we're planning on doing one in about 20 minutes, if that's okay with you. Okay, I'll look out for anything as well. Thanks, Sam. Okay, cheers. Bye. Right, okay. Where did I put my glasses on? I fell down. Okay, so we've got to predict the flight now. So, do you want me to do that to camera?
Mm-hmm.
It's fine now.
Let me see if I can get the screen from here with this.
Well, I can always do a couple of screenshots as well.
Because there's so much glare off that screen, it's really hard to see.
Yeah.
All I'm getting is your reflection in it.
Alright. That's it, flat out. Can it come more over my shoulder or something? Is that any better?
No, it's just, it is just glare. I mean, you can see a rough outline of it.
That doesn't matter too much, really. I'll just say I'm just predicting the flight now. About right.
Okay, so turn and face the camera. Yeah? I can focus that close, don't worry. Okay, go on.
Hi, well, I'm just predicting the flight right now. I'm going to see where it will land if we launch it and it goes up to the expected altitude.
Yeah, it's best.
about ready to go.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, did you want to save it?
Yeah.
Scary.
kilos of neck lift.
Okay, so wherever you want to go.
Okay. Well, do you start recording again?
I will do.
Okay.
So I need to focus. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so I've worked out I needed 2.1 kilos of neck lift, so I'm going to weigh out that amount in water and tie that onto the fill tube, and then when the balloon is neutrally buoyant we know we've got enough gas in the balloon.
Cool, that's done.
Midgets?
Yeah, we put down inside the fish.
So, I'll stand on this corner here.
Okay,
yeah.
Be on from there?
Yeah. So, just guide us through in a sec, when I say go, everything you're doing and why. Okay, go.
So, I'm getting a couple of bottles of water, which unfortunately seem to be exactly 3.1 kilos together, and by my cutters, I'm going to tie them together. Well, I had some cutters in there earlier. gas on. Thank you.
minute. Come back. Mine is really long, painful type work for me. This one, this step. Really all I'm doing is making sure that it works when I'm done there. Thank you. go, I'm going to tie this now to something heavy. Like this cylinder. Good to go, right, just need to check everything's working still, and then we get to launch it.
Okay. 20 gigs used, more than.
Still working.
Are we still streaming?
Yep.
Good.
Good. Right, well, good to go.
Yeah. But, Steve, as soon as you launch it, did you want to
run back and start snapping with this?
Okay.
Put it on.
Yeah.
Yeah. And set it all.
Right. That's all good to go.
Okay. Ready, Eddie?
So if you just make the announcement and say, right, I've checked everything and double checked it, and now I know I'm happy, and then...
So everything's been checked and double checked, and I'm happy to launch. The only planes I can hear are the ones in the sky at about 20,000 feet. So we're good to go. Run. really hard to just take one shot.
Yeah.
Ah, I'll show you something. There's a button here as well. He's got to hold it that way.
Oh, right. Which button? Oh, that button there?
Yeah.
It seemed to want to fire when I held it, by the way. Does it swap buttons as you turn it?
No, both are all the way back.
Oh, okay.
That 1D, we've got a built-in battery grip, and with a 5D here, you have to actually have one.
It's a heavy game,
It is, isn't it? Piece of camera, final piece. Well, not final, well, but for here.
So, it's... You ready?
Sorry. Again.
Yeah. So the balloon's all nicely launched and seems to be going up nicely. So all that really remains is to take a few more photographs of it from the ground and then pack away and head off after it. I don't want to be squinting, but I do that when I... Food, I think. Going. Still sending its pictures down. So
let's have a look at its pictures.
That's like, there's not none yet in the air. It's quite a way behind from what I can work out. That's missing the last one that is on the ground.
Oh, I see. Some of these have got packets missing.
Yeah, they will have. Yeah, until you get a few listings.
What, even with us?
Well, we should. I mean, we should do. We should be getting perfect. So, get there. Never noticed it being completely perfect. The single string of it. And then it's off the ground. Bit of spinning going on.
Is there a program on here to see the actual raw data coming down?
Yes, there is, yeah. So if you go to the... I think the raw data's coming down. If you go to the... That program.
That's it there?
That's it there.
Okay.
That's it coming in from, over our connection. We got to eat.
still see it.
Yeah, it's pretty clear, isn't it? Where?
Just in that clear bit. See where you got like two clouds in the middle of that? Mm-hmm. Straight up from that, just where it's starting the new layer of cloud. Is it?
No. Don't need my glasses on. So there's two little clouds together.
Yeah.
In the middle of that.
Yeah.
Blue patch.
Straight up from the cloud on the left.
No.
Yeah. Straight up. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Where the other cloud layer is, that big
mm-hmm.
cloud layer.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Up from that a little bit.
Oh right.
See it?
No. Oh yeah. Sorry. Yeah. There it is.
Cool. I've got a lot of floaters in my eyes.
That cloud there must be quite high up, because it's below it. Is it still? It's just entering a little blue patch there. Here we go.
No. Good light.
I can still see it. But if I put my eye up, it wouldn't. Can't be sure really. I think I can still see it. Oh yeah, there it goes, going through another blue patch. That's it doing ascent ways. Nice. Hopefully that's good. It's probably it's going to speed up a bit, so.
Right, what should we do with the live stream?
Well, we'll pack away and then we'll close it down. Don't know if we, whether we want to do it in the car or not. Really.
I think it will cut out, but
okay.
It's up to you.
We'll not do it in the car then. Yeah.
If it cuts out for like less than 20 seconds or so, it comes back, that auto reconnect works. But when we drive down there, it certainly cuts out down there. And then it's touch and go on, you know, like the A14.
Hmm. No, let's not do that. Well, just actually, it's probably a good idea to pack away. That's looking a bit grim over there.
Mm.
Right. Up north. bum bum.
Doing stunts.
That is dinner. Come back to do some more stunts. That's fortunate. You're there, aren't you? Good idea, actually. And, I'll just close down the live stream, I think. I'll just say a few words. Okay, guys, thanks for the watching. We've just launched the balloon reasonably successfully. We just packed away and so we're heading off. I'm going to close the live stream. Cheers. I said looking at the microphone. Stop the live stream.